Well, Congress now working in overtime this week on a series of spending plans that could affect us all. With a pair of key deadlines approaching, our Washington correspondent Matt Knadler is tracking your money.
This week, two problems seeking two solutions in Congress. First, the threat of a government shutdown at the end of the month. The U.S. House on Tuesday racing to pass a short-term spending measure that would fund the government through early December. But here's the catch. House Democrats have attached that spending plan to a bill that suspends the debt ceiling until December 2022. That's the amount of money the federal government can borrow.
Should Republicans careen our country towards a default, our country could actually be plunged into recession.
Republicans have pledged not to raise the debt limit, arguing Democrats can raise that limit themselves if they want to pass the $3.5 trillion budget reconciliation package without GOP support.
The debt ceiling was suspended for 2 years. I did not support that. Okay, I think that when we're going to talk about spending money, we should have to face the American people and advocate for doing that.
Democrats argue raising the debt limit has always been a bipartisan effort. Now, by tying the two together, they're forcing Republicans to essentially vote for the deal or vote for a government shutdown. The U.S. has never defaulted on its debt. Treasury officials warn the U.S. will hit its borrowing limit sometime in early to mid-October, forcing members of Congress to work overtime this week.
They're looking at not just $3.5 trillion. Let's put it, they're almost $5 trillion when you put in their infrastructure bill that is not infrastructure.
Congress has to pass a budget or stopgap measure by the end of the month or risk that government shutdown, a perfect storm brewing with the clock ticking. In Washington, Matt Knadler reporting.